Up to date, the probably biggest study on the foot in the mouth effect, at least in respect to the number of participants, is the study by the French scientists Meineri and Guéguen, published in 2011 in the Journal of Applied Social Psychology. And the title of the study is "I hope I'm not disturbing you, am I? Another operationalization of the foot in the mouth paradigm." And as the title of the study tells us, they tried to find out whether the foot in the mouth effect can be obtained with another common phrase, which is often used when you're approached from salespeople on the street or when somebody calls you and wants you to participate in a survey. And this is exactly the scenario they tested in this study with an incredible number of participants. They had 1,791 subjects who they called and asked whether they were willing to participate in a survey. They had three experimental conditions. In the first one, they used the foot in the mouth technique by beginning the conversation with the phrase, "I hope I'm not disturbing you, am I?" In a second condition, which was already a control condition, they also used this phrase, but they didn't allow the other person to respond to the phrase. So they said, "I hope I'm not disturbing you, am I?" And then they quickly went on to say, "You probably know the regional daily paper, Le Telegram, at least by name." "Well, for our studies, we are carrying out a survey on this newspaper. Would you have a few minutes to answer by phone? There are only yes or no questions, so it should go very fast." From a methodological point of view, it was very important to have this control group in order to rule out the possibility that the effects of the technique are not due to the extended length of the request and are not due to perceived kindness. Even though, to be true, this cannot be completely ruled out by this experimental condition. And they also had a third condition, also a control condition, in which they didn't use the phrase at all. And it turned out that in comparison to the two control conditions, the use of the "I hope I'm not disturbing you, am I?" phrase was more effective. And isn't it baffling that such small interventions, such small changes in the approach can have such a significant effect? I mean, it's just one single sentence. It's not magic, it's just one single sentence.